Hey guys, Brian from Brian Boas here. The 2021 boa breeding season is just around the corner, and I'm going to be pairing up my animals pretty soon. Today I want to show you some of my non-redtail boa pairs that I plan on pairing up for the 2021 breeding season. If you want to follow my Locality Boa breeding trials and learn all about keeping and breeding these wonderful animals in captivity, please be sure to subscribe to the Brian Boas YouTube channel. I'm really excited about the 2021 boa breeding season. This year I'll have about a dozen or so pairs. It'll be a record number for me. And I have several localities that are very rarely bred in captivity. So I'm really looking forward to this. And every year is definitely a learning experience for me. So it's great to learn new things about breeding boas. And the only way you can really do this is just to actually breed the boas. So I did a couple videos previously, last week and the week before, about my redtail boa breeding, my true redtail boa pairs that I'm going to be pairing up. Today I want to do the first of two videos on my non-redtail boa, locality boa pairs that I'm going to be breeding attempting to breed in 2021. So first we have a very rare Central American locality boa. This is the Honduran firebelly boa. This is my female. She's one of my more bitey snakes. So I'm, you know, hopefully she'll behave today, but I'm just going to be a little cautious handling her. But the Honduran firebellies are said to come from an island called Roatan off of the coast of Honduras. This isn't entirely clear. It's somewhat of a mystery, but they're a beautiful Central American boa. You can see the famous feature is their orange, pink, reddish belly. And this particular female really has a nice belly. She's one of the nicest firebellies I've ever seen. The Honduran firebellies are pretty rare. In fact, I don't know of anyone else who's breeding them. I produced a litter 2 years ago, but unfortunately, most of them were born premature. Well, they were all born prematurely. And of the litter of, I think it was like 13 babies, all but two passed away. They were basically born, stillborn, because she delivered about 2 weeks early for some reason that I don't understand. That was actually her second litter. She produced a litter before that that was all healthy. And actually I held back some of those animals. But I'm hoping that I'll get a good litter this year and I won't have her deliver prematurely. She's gotten a little bit bigger. This is probably about as big as she'll get. And she's, you know, somewhat of a challenge to handle, you know, definitely not my most docile boa, but she's a beautiful animal. The firebellies also have this beautiful, orangish reddish eye collar. Just a cool looking boa. And if you've been looking for a firebelly, make sure you follow this because, as I said, these animals really don't become available very often. And this is my male Honduran firebelly. So you can see this guy's a little bit smaller than the female. He's probably about maybe 4.5 feet or so. This guy doesn't quite have the same belly color. You see his belly is quite a bit paler than my female, but what he has is a mostly patternless body. You can see he has very few saddles, and in my litters that I produced in the past, I had several animals that both had the patternless body plus the beautiful coloration on the belly. And I actually held back some of those. This guy's interesting boa. You can see another feature is he's got this really short head and he's got these kind of bulging eyes. He almost looks like a frog. It's kind of he's one of the more unusual shaped heads in my boas. This guy's a little bit more mellow than the female. You can see he's, you know, pretty easy to handle and he just kind of chills out. But he was successful with the female for two previous litters, so hopefully he'll repeat his success and I'll have a nice litter of firebellies that'll be born sometime in the summer of 2021. The next locality boa I'm going to try to breed next year is going to be a first for me if I'm successful, and that's my Coupes Pastel Colombian boas. And so the Coupes Pastel project was started by a European breeder who selected for the most orangey pastel of normal Colombian boas, and he bred those together. And then he bred the offspring together and selected for multiple generations until he got these boas that had this beautiful orangey pastel coloration. And actually the project was continued by Vin Russo, who continued to select for more additionally boldly colored orangey pastel animals. And my pair came from Vin Russo. They were 2015 babies. And so unfortunately the female isn't shed. It seems like every time I film a video, at least one of my animals that I feature is in shed. So her colors are not quite as bright as they normally are, but you can see the beautiful orangey coloration. This female really has this exceptional orangish coloration, even for the Coupe's pastel. But these are a cool boa. I've actually been featuring them in my videos on pet boas and normal boas because that's basically what they are. They're pure Colombian. They're not a morph. They're a selectively bred bloodline for this beautiful coloration. And they're really good as far as like a first-time boa for a beginner. They're just simple to care for. They're docile and they're enjoyable to handle as well as really beautiful to look at. So hopefully these guys will breed for me next year. And I'll have some of these Coupe's pastel available sometime in the summer of 2021. I'll be pairing that female Coupe's pastel with this male. So this guy, you can see his coloration isn't quite as deep as far as the orange. He's kind of more of a light, pale, peachy, kind of creamy peach coloration. He's got a really nice pattern. You can see he's got kind of a circle back in terms of his saddles. And like the female, he's a pretty laid back animal, just your nice, beautiful looking normal boa. Unfortunately, you can see he's developed a bit of a swollen nose. This guy tends to rub on his cage quite a bit. And he had this issue before, and actually I transferred him from a sliding glass cage to a tub and he seemed to heal up, but now it seems to come back. So I'm gonna have to try giving him some additional hiding places or mixing things up a bit, and hopefully he'll stop doing that. With these Coupe's pastel boas, they're not really a morph boa because they're basically normal. They don't really have any genes other than the normal boa genes. But then they're not, I feel uncomfortable saying it's a true locality boa because they've been selectively bred for this beautiful coloration. So they are pure Colombian boas. But if you went to Colombia, you probably wouldn't be able to find a boa like this just because they've been altered through captive selection, selective breeding in captivity. But regardless, they're cool boas, enjoyable to keep as a pet, and hope to have some babies of these guys sometime in the summer. Another pairing I'm really excited about are my Pearl Island boas, Boa constrictor sabogae. And I first bred these back in 2019, I got a litter of five babies. This is my female, so she'll be bred to the same male for the second time. And so the Pearl Island boa is a very divergent form of boa constrictor. They're the most elongated boas. They have this really long body that's suited to living in trees. And they also have a very unusual head shape. It's kind of an elongated head with these flared nostrils and these really bulging eyes. A really cool looking boa. They're not the calmest boa. If you want a pet that you can just handle and is just gonna hang out, this is not gonna be your best choice. But a very unique and beautiful boa. They were actually originally classified in the genus Epicrides. So completely separate genus from boas and reclassified as a subspecies of boa constrictor in the middle of the 20th century. So this female actually escaped on me earlier this year. Somehow she got out of her tub through the back. So luckily I found her about a month later and I've corrected the situation, so there's no way she can escape. You know, actually I did a video recently about escapes, so you might want to check that out if you haven't watched it already. But regardless of how careful you are, there's always the possibility that your boa is going to escape. And the video I did on escaped boas gives you some hints about how to find them and how to prevent escapes. But back to the sabogae. Hopefully I'll have a nice litter from her this year. I think she gave birth back in June. She was one of the earliest births that I've had. So hopefully this will be one of my first litters that's produced in 2021, the sabogae. And you can see a cool boa, not a huge boa, kind of a mid-sized boa, but this beautiful lack of pattern and this beautiful creamy white belly. Just a unique looking form of boa constrictor. The Pearl Island Boa. This is my male Pearl Island Boa, and of course he's in shed. You can see his eye is all clouded up. Normally he's a bit lighter than this and a bit more brightly colored, but you can see he's got this beautiful mostly patternless body with basically no saddles at all. He's got a few saddles on his tail that are kind of this deep brownish orange color. And this guy was successful breeding to the female I just showed you in 2019. I actually paired him up with another female in 2020, and I didn't get any babies. And I'm not quite sure why. It looked like I was observing breeding activity. Maybe the female was not quite ready. She hadn't been bred before. But hopefully we'll be successful in 2021 with his first female that he got paired with. And these Pearl Island boas are just a cool looking boa from a small island off of the coast of Panama in the Pacific, and just very unique look to them. I have one more locality boa pairing to share with you today, and that's actually a repairing from 2020. This is a pair that didn't successfully breed for me in 2020, so I'm going to give it another try in 2021, and that's my long tail boas, Boa constrictor longicauda. This is the female. So she's a Basset bloodline animal. She's got these beautiful dark colors. I just love the head and facial markings of these longicauda boas. They just have these beautiful dark black splotches across their cheeks and the top of their head. And then you can see all of the speckling on their bellies. Really a cool looking dark boa. They start off much lighter and they develop their dark pigment as they grow. Kind of like the IMG morph boa, but a naturally occurring form of it. They're a kind of mid-sized boa. They don't get more than about 5 or 6 feet typically. And I haven't bred these before. It was my first attempt in 2020. So it'd be really great to have the experience of breeding these animals. And I have my fingers crossed for 2021. So we'll just have to see what happens with these longicauda. And the last boa for today's video, this is my male longicauda boa that I paired up with that female earlier this year, and I wasn't successful, and I'm still not entirely sure. I did witness quite a bit of what appeared to be breeding activity. This guy was obviously courting the female, and I saw them tail to tail a number of times. I even saw the tip of his tail was kind of twitching, which is a pretty sure sign that they're copulating. So I don't know exactly what happened. Hopefully there's not any kind of biological or reproductive issue with either of these animals. You know, maybe it was just they needed practice the first year, and hopefully next year I'll be more successful. If I'm not, 2 years in a row, I'll have to think about switching it up a bit, but we'll give them another shot next year. And so I have a few more pairings, and I plan on releasing another video. This video will cover my dwarf boas, so stay tuned. That'll be out next week or the week after that. And all of these animals, I'm going to start to cycle in late November, and I'll plan on pairing them up, most of them in December. If you want to learn about breeding boas in captivity, I plan on releasing videos going over every step along the way. So it's your chance to get a look at my approach to breeding boas. Please be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're interested, so you don't miss out on these upcoming breeding videos. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to shoot me a line. Thanks for watching, and enjoy your boas.